Hey everyone, Mr. Spicy here with a quick tip for you in the No Man's Sky Companions update. With the update, we now have the ability to have our own pets, which gives us a variety of animals we can collect and, you know, teach certain things, really basically by adjusting their stats and their height, things like that. Now, to do this, you get an egg, you go to the egg sequencer, and you put the egg in, like I'm going to do with iKenny's one here. And let's say I want to increase the height. I throw in some platinum. I get it saying increasing height. I could go to the neural calibrator and say throw in platinum as well. And devotion is increasing. So here is iKenny with a height of 2.7 meters and a level of 19% on the devotion level. iKenny's offspring, however, is going to have some different stats. It went up 0.5 meters in height, and now the devotion is a positive instead of a negative, which it was independent before. So we went by 20% increase in devotion and a 0.5 meter increase in height. But what happens if you sequence it more than once with the egg? While it doesn't make sense that you would do multiple sequences, I mean, logically, I would just go ahead and max out the height the first time if that was the option. But just for argument's sake, let's try doing more than one. So again, iKenny is 2.7 meters and 19% on the independent level, meaning basically negative on the devotion. But the offspring with two cycles is now 3.7 meters high and 21% devoted. So where one cycle we went up by 0.5 meters and 20%, we've now gone up by a full meter and 40% based on two cycles. So right now, if I do 10 cycles, I should see this go up by 5 meters, right? Well, no, not exactly. Here I have the iKenny egg again, with 6 cycles of sequencing, which means I should be seeing an increase to 5.7 meters, and this should be pretty much maxed out on devotion. So now with the new creature, the offspring, I have completely loyal 100% devotion, but my height stopped at 4 meters. So what this means is that no matter how many cycles you do, some creatures are just going to max out on their height for that species. However, you can do however many cycles you need to max out their stats, which means taking the opportunity, you can get some really big creatures, assuming the species allows for that, as well as getting some creatures that are perfectly 100% in whatever direction you want them to be. So if I take this other creature that has a placefulness value, and the first run I put in oxygen to increase the helpfulness, you see it says decreasing. But without even hatching the egg, just doing a second sequence, by adding the oxygen again, now my helpfulness is increasing because I'm actually going into the positive for a helpfulness, as opposed to before it was negative, being not so helpful, meaning playful. So now let's look at the parent versus offspring for this one. The parent here is 5.8 meters in height and was playful, 28% playful, cheeky. But the offspring is actually now 8.8 meters in height, which ties in pretty much where I wanted it to be because I did 6 rotations. So that is 3 meters increase from 6 rotations. Plus, I went to a positive on the helpfulness at 92%. So if I had done one more for helpfulness, this would actually be 100%. And then 2 more on the devotion would be at 100%. And 1 more on gentleness, I could have it at 100% if that is what I wanted. But again, height is going to be limited based on your species. So you're not going to be able to take some little creepy crawly thing and turn it into a gargantuan thing at 20 meters in height. What this does mean, however, is instead of having to do multiple eggs, you can actually sequence one egg to get all of these stats where you want, get the height as big as you can possibly get, and then you're done. Other than, of course, color and your, you know, variations on the look of the creature. This is where I have one more tip. Do all the changes you need for your height and your stats, and then go back to your ship in the anomaly so you get a restore point. This way you could go back and experiment with the mutations for the look of the creature as well as the color scheme without having to do multiple iterations to get the stats where you wanted. So while this doesn't really make sense that you have to do multiple sequences for something that I would just do in one if I was doing this kind of thing, but you can do it, and that means you don't have to do multiple eggs and, you know, multiple long periods of waiting to get the right creature. You just have to find the basic one you want and then manipulate it from there on the very next egg. That's it for this video, so thanks for watching, and make sure you check out my other No Man's Sky content.